students, and welcome again. And in this video we'll talk here biosynthesis of serine and glycine, and this is the one of the selective topics of biochemistry. So biosynthesis means how this synthesis occurs in our bodies. So serine and glycine are two amino acid, and the how this serine and glycine synthesis in our bodies. So we'll talk here, that is biosynthesis of serine and glycine. So let's talk here. So first let's see the structure of serine. So this is the structure of serine, and so another, that is the glycine. So this is here, that is the structure of glycine, and this is my book. So okay, so here you can see this is the structure of glycine, and that is first amino acid. So clear or not, this is the structure of glycine, and finally our, this is the structure of our, so serine. So let's talk here, you can see. So 3-phosphoglycerate is the precursor for the biosynthesis of serine and glycine. So these 3-phosphoglycerate are the smallest organic compound that is precursor for the synthesis of that serine and glycine. And here synthesis started from, that is smallest organic compound, that is phosphoglycerate. So let's talk here, and if you here you can see these steps are completed into three, these reactions are completed into three steps. That is, first one is oxidation, then after here transamination, and third one is our dephosphorylation. So these 3-phosphoglycerates converted into serine into three steps. So first one is our oxidation, then after transamination, and then after dephosphorylation. Okay, so let's talk here one by one. So this is the structure of 3-phosphoglycerate. So this is alcohol. These undergo oxidation, and that is secondary alcohol, and you know secondary alcohol oxidized to form ketone. So this is here, all the atoms are same here you can see, but here alcohol, that is secondary grade alcohol, are converted into ketones. So and this is the oxidation. So here one of the oxidizing agent, that is NAD plus, reduced to form NADH plus H plus, and here one enzyme work, that is called phosphoglycerate dehydrogenase, because here loss of hydrogen means oxidation. So phosphoglycerate dehydrogenase, from here name, that is phosphoglycerate, and it lost the hydrogen, so that is phosphoglycerate dehydrogenase. And that is the, so here name, that is 3-phosphohydroxy, that is what is this, pyruvate. So this is the 3-phosphohydroxy pyruvate. Now that is undergo transamination, and if you remember in my previously we already discussed about transamination. So transamination means this keto acid, that is pyruvate, receive NH2 from another NH2 group, that is glutamate, and these glutamates are converted into keto acid, that is alpha ketoglutarate. So these glutamate gives NH2 group to the these pyruvate, and it takes O group itself, and that convert into alpha ketoglutarate. So this here, that gives, so transamination, that is here one enzyme, that is phosphoserine aminotransferase. Okay, so here in presence of C, this double bond here, NH3 plus. Okay, so this is named 3-phosphoserine. So we obtain here, that is, but here 3-phosphoserine. So we have to loss, we have to remove one phosphate group from here. So this undergo, that goes dephosphorylation, and in presence of enzyme, that is, so it gives here you can see finally our serine. So serine. Now second one is our glycine. So here So this is CH2O. So we have to loss this group, that is CH2O group. So these three phosphoserine, and so this is serine. So this serine loss, that is serine hydroxymethyl transferase. So these undergo serine hydroxymethyl transferase, and with the loss of water molecules in presence of PLP decarbonation, and that forms finally our structure. Here you can see that is glycine, and in this way you can synthesis serine and glycine from 3-phosphoglycerate. And hope you this video is useful for you, and thank you so much. And if you have any confusion about these topics as well as another topics, you can share comment, and thank you so much for watching.